I am not a politician. Hi there, welcome to my channel. If you're a new subscriber, thank you so much for joining me. Thank you so much, welcome. As you can see, this video is actually 5 months old, but I decided to put it out there today for a specific reason, or actually an important reason. As you know, today is our Independence Day, so why not share the story? This is amazing for me, well, to me. So, yeah. The video is not that long, but I decided to add on some pictures and explain more just for you to get a better understanding of where I went, what I did, what I discovered, what I've learned. Before we jump into our video, I would like to say two things. One, I am not a politician. Two, consider subscribing. It's going to help me so much. It will help me quite a lot. Support me. You can support me by subscribing. So please do consider subscribing right now. The reason why I shared this video is because, one, I think that a lot of Congolese people actually don't know. Well, not that they don't know. They know the story, but they haven't seen what actually happened. They haven't seen the footage. They haven't seen the office. So that's why I decided to actually share the story. Two, you often see all those movie directors, journalists, all these people who actually leave their countries. They could be from America, they could be from Europe, they could be from China, Australia, all over the world. They will actually leave their continent, come to Africa and actually document. It's not necessarily about political history. It could be about our culture, where we come from and all that. They will actually document what happened. And the next thing you know, you'll be watching it on Discovery Channel or Nat Geo, which is not a bad thing. It's actually good that people actually get to see what happened in our countries. They actually get to see our history, our political history, our cultural history, where we come from and all that. It's not a bad idea at all. But I also think that YouTube is actually a great platform for people to put their stuff out there, as video creators, as it's a great platform to share these kind of stories. So since today is an Independence Day, why not share? Before we jump into our video, I decided, you know, why not try to explain the whole video in French, even though my French is not that good. So for those who only speak French can understand what I'm actually talking about in the video. Without further ado, let's jump into our video.
Le Palais de Marbre a été conçu par l'architecte Fernand Talangay dans les années 70 à la demande du directeur de la Banque nationale du Zaïre pour son propre usage. Et en 1997, Laurent-Désiré Kabila en fait sa résidence. Le palais de marbre est blanc. Il est situé dans un parc qui a la forme de la RDC. Wow, guys, isn't that awesome? Avec 430 mètres d'altitude, c'est qui offre une belle vue de toute la ville. Beautiful. À l'occasion du 19e anniversaire de sa mort, le 16 janvier, le mausolée est ouvert aux visiteurs ainsi que son bureau du palais de marbre.
La caméra dans le cœur, mais l'oiseau tout là-haut.
This is us walking in his office, as you can see. Those are some of the pictures of his funeral. This is just a view of his office. Pictures of his funeral. What you see behind me are the clothes that he wore on the day of his death. That's him with Muammar Gaddafi. The couch that you see at the end there, where the guy is sitting, is exactly where he was shot.
Regarde les ces oiseaux de pluie, ces oiseaux de pleurs. Regarde-les tous ces oiseaux, ces oiseaux de pluie, ces oiseaux de pleurs.
Merci beaucoup d'avoir suivi ma vidéo. Merci beaucoup, ça me fait énormément plaisir. N'oubliez surtout pas de vous abonner, ça me fera vraiment vraiment plaisir. Merci beaucoup, vous Congolais, à vous tous. Bonne journée d'indépendance à tous Congolaises et Congolaises. Merci beaucoup, à la prochaine. Bye guys.